People arrive at a busy airport news kiosk at a rate that is uniformly distributed between 5 and 10 seconds. Most people buy only one paper, which takes an average of 6 seconds, but may be as little as 3 or as much as 9 seconds, and 20% buy two papers, which takes between 6 and 12 seconds to buy. We want to model this using SimQuick in Excel. First thing you need to do is draw a sketch. Here's a very simple process model. People enter the kiosk. They have to wait in line because there's usually somebody there ahead of them buying something. And then while they're waiting, they need to decide if they're going to buy one paper or two papers. They then go to the clerk. They either buy one paper, which takes a relatively short amount of time, or they buy two papers, which takes more time. And then once they get their paper, they leave. Okay, I brought up an Excel workbook containing SimQuick. I'm going to start by showing you what the model of that process looks like when you set it up in SimQuick. Click on View Model, and it opens up. Starts out with our simulation controls again, where we put in the parameters that control the simulation, and I'm going to leave that to you to figure out. We have an entrance, and in this case, it's named Kiosk. I think I've mentioned that SimQuick is very particular about how you name things. So be aware if you capitalize something, put an underline in one space, spell it differently, it'll get you into trouble. So you should go through, first of all, and create the elements, just making the names, so that when you start to connect things, you'll be able to see the correct names, however you created them in the drop-downs. Here in this kiosk, we've got our arrival time, and as you recall, it was a uniform distribution between 5 and 10 minutes, and we're getting one person at a time. You could have groups come in, 2, 3, or 4, but in our model, we've got one person entering at a time. And then the output from that entrance goes to a waiting line, which is a buffer. You should almost always have a buffer between elements in your process. It just makes things work more smoothly. It's kind of like grease. We have two workstations here. In order to model the fact that it takes more time to buy two papers than to buy one paper, you need two workstation elements in your SimQuick model. Here we just named them one paper with a uniform distribution between 3 and 9 seconds, and two papers with a uniform distribution between 6 and 12. Remember, if you click in the window and use the drop-down, you can see the various types of distributions that you can use in your particular problem. We'll use the standard distributions, and you just have to input the required parameters. We won't be using these custom distributions, which you can create to get more elaborate models. You need to specify the output, which element it goes to, how many objects come out of that particular workstation, and then the resources needed. And this particular student forgot the resources in this particular situation. There has to be a clerk that mans these two workstations, and that resource should be set up. I'll show you how to do that. In order to make the model work again, we need the buffers, and we created a waiting line. Once you enter, you wait in line, then you tell it the capacity. For most cases, is going to be unlimited, but you may have a limited space in your waiting room. And the initial number of objects can be set at 0 or whatever you think may be there. And you can actually put distributions in here in order to get some random values in those. Here it shows the output from the buffer is to checkout, which is the clerk that's going to ring up your purchase, and one person at a time leaves the waiting line. This other buffer is the exit. When people finish buying, they go into a buffer, and you need to name it. Initial capacity is unlimited and nobody there to begin with, and there's no output because that's the end of your model. We do have a decision point in this model. We're calling it checkout. Could be whatever you want. You can see that the buffer, waiting line buffer, goes to the checkout point, and you make a decision. You either buy one paper, and then it's 80% of the people, or two papers, 20% of the people, and it shows you the destinations. Out of the decision point, you go to the one paper workstation 80% of the time, or the two papers workstation 20% of the time. So that's an overview of how you would set this up.